Hey, this is Xander.
And Haley.
And Mr. S.
Today we are back to the Union Weekly podcast. We're going to be talking with Mr. Barilla, our school social worker, where he discusses his educational journey from his and insights from his time at Union. We'll also cover important updates, including next year's registration and the attendance competition and yearbook group photo day and PTSA news are going to also be said too. So let's get started.
All right, welcome back to the Union Weekly podcast.
Hey, Mr. Barilla.
Hi, Xander.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm good. So you've been here at Union for 2 years?
This is my second year, yep.
Nice. And you came from Corner Canyon?
Corner Canyon.
Nice. So can you introduce yourself and share a little bit about your background in education?
Sure. I'm Mr. Barilla. I'm the school social worker here at Union. I've been in education for, I guess this is my 12th year.
Wow.
I started at a school downtown called Horizonte. It's like an alternative high school, teaching English and history. And then when I moved to Corner Canyon, I taught English and developed an at-risk program for that high school. And I got my first master's degree in social work a few years ago, like 4 years ago. And then I decided to make the change, I guess, in 2022, I guess. And I got assigned Union. And
nice.
Here I am. Yeah.
What does a typical day look like for you as a social worker?
Lots of different things. My main focus is the social-emotional learning of students. So that can look like if a kid's in crisis, they come down, they need someone to talk to, someone to work out or process whatever feelings they're feeling at the time. It can be running groups from anything from like kids struggling with anxiety, depression, to ADHD, to how to turn their homework in on time, lots of different things like that. It's mostly focused on social emotional learning for students.
What inspired you to become a social worker?
Lots of different things. I've had a lot of friends, family members who've suffered from mental health issues. That was one driving factor. Another one was that my work with at-risk students made me realize I need a lot more education in social emotional, stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I need to be well versed in that. And so I thought it was a good fit. It gives you a lot of options. There's a lot of stuff you can do in the schools, outside of schools with social work. So I thought it was a good fit for me.
Nice.
What are some of the biggest challenges you face in your role?
That I have many roles, that it's not just one thing that I have to come and do. Mm. When I was a teacher, it was pretty clearly defined, like you come in, you teach your classes, and you prepare lessons, grade papers, and that was it. But as a social worker, I might get pulled into doing some minor administrative stuff. I get pulled to do different teams. If I have a set agenda for the day, a lot of times it gets wiped out because I have kids who need some support. So it's just like managing a bunch of different hats at once, I'd say.
What advice would you give to students dealing with common challenges like stress and peer pressure?
I'd say don't keep it in. Talk to someone. We have a ton of great adults here at the school, not just me or the counselors. Administrators are great. Your teachers are great. They all are trained in some way to help deal with your problems, to help you out. And if you need to come and visit us, we're right right down in the main office. Also, I always want to remind students, like, it's normal. Whatever you're feeling, most of the other students are probably feeling as well. So don't feel like you'd be a weirdo or you'd be an outcast if you came forward and told someone how you were feeling, because we've heard it all before.
Do you have any interesting or crazy stories from your year in education?
Well, I've told Xander the story before, and he loves it, so I'm going to tell it again. So when I was working at that school downtown, I was teaching, and last day of the quarter rolls around, and it's the end of the day, school's out, everyone's gone, I thought, except for me. I'm just grading papers. One of my students walks in. I say, hey. He doesn't say anything. He's acting a little nervous, a little shady. Walks over to my desk, pulls out a crisp $100 bill. It was the nicest $100 bill I've ever seen. Puts it on the table, slides it over, and says something like, so, do I have an A? And naturally, I took the $100 bill and gave him an A. No, I'm just kidding. Never would have done that ever. I just slid it back and said, maybe it's time you go home. That was the only time a kid's ever tried to bribe me with, like, actual cash.
Wow.
Yeah. Anything, quite interesting.
Has anything like that happened to you, Mr. S?
Not with money. My kids knew how much I loved Mountain Dew. All of a sudden, one day I walk into my room. I don't know how my door got unlocked. And there's a 24-pack just sitting on my desk. I'm like,
nice.
What's going on? I'm like, oh, well, I opened them, stuck them in my mini fridge, and one of my students came by later, and he's like, hey, did you see the gift I left on your desk? I'm like, so many questions. First off, how did you get in? And so we discussed it. He's like, can I get excused from doing this one assignment? I'm like, you know what? Sure, it's only worth 20% of his grade. He's not passing anyway, so... Sure, you don't have to do the assignment. He wasn't going to do it anyway, so might as well keep the Mountain Dew. And I gave him a 10 out of 10, which accounted for 20% of his grade, so his grade percentage went up 1 point.
1 point.
Yeah.
You're going to get a lot of Mountain Dew in the next week.
Well, before grades are due. Good thing is I've given up soda, so.
You have?
Yeah.
What? What did you give up soda?
Oh, you haven't seen? I haven't had soda since we came into the new year.
Oh, I swear I've seen Mountain Dew's on your desk.
Nope.
All right, well, let's get on with our upcoming event and announcements, and I think we have a message from our sponsor.
Oh, yeah. This episode of the Union Weekly Podcast is brought to you by the Bobcat Market. Spend your PBIS points here, get all the cool new stuff, get food, get school supplies. Go check it out. Make sure you bring your card, and you can earn some cool rewards by using your PBIS points. Again, this episode to you is brought to you by the Bobcat Market. All right, let's talk about some upcoming events and announcements. Just a reminder, the second quarter ends on January 11th, so we'll be moving into the third quarter. There will be no school on January 12th to allow teachers to complete grading. Also, no school the Monday after that, because of Martin Luther King Jr. Day. So we'll have a 4-day week.
Yes.
Yeah, I know. Right after Christmas break.
Even better.
Next year registration, incoming sixth graders orientation on January 29th at 9:30 a.m., including building tours and registration guidance.
I think that's in the counseling center, or where is that?
Well, the counseling center is in charge of it.
Okay.
But... not sure exactly how they're rolling that out.
Okay, I just find it kind of weird. It's during school.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, it starts at 9:30. So,
but they'll take care of it.
Yeah, they'll take care of it.
Then there's a parent information evening for parents of incoming sixth graders on January 29th, the same day, at 6 p.m. And there'll be a scavenger hunt for registration information.
It's going to be a lot of fun. We got some stuff planned.
Fun. Counselor sessions, counselors to discuss next year's registration with current 6th and 7th graders throughout February, and then the Hillcrest counselors will be coming February 7th for the 8th graders.
Yeah.
And so I get to help with you guys doing that again.
Oh, you're helping with it?
Well, yeah, they come into your class and help you do it. So. Also, reminder for language and behavior. There has been an increased use of racial slurs and inappropriate language. There's going to be a formation of a group to promote positive language.
I mean, y'all know how I am in my class. I don't even let it get away.
Yeah.
So, like, guys, just don't do it. It's stupid. Like, don't use it.
Facts. So the January attendance competition, we're still competing for the best attendance, and the winner gets an extra 5 minutes of lunch.
Cutthroat trout's going to win.
Doubtful. And I think, Mrs. McCann said it was going to be on like a orange chicken day too.
Yeah, that's what she said last week.
Since everybody loves that.
Yeah.
Magazines are requested for the health classes. They need old magazines or catalogs for a project. And yearbook group photo day is scheduled for January 24th.
That's a Wednesday.
In first period and likely concluding by third. And parenting classes led by Diana Johnson, starting February 3rd, every Tuesday from 6 to 8 p.m. in the Bobcat Den. Topics include teen development, communication, family conflict, and more.
And I think there's more information on Student Square about that. All right, so attendance. Just be sure you're on time to your classes. Teachers hate when you're late, and it's also not good to be late because it's not good in the workforce either. Be respectful to everyone. There's the no gum policy still. It's still not ended. And food is still in the cafeteria only. And then be sure to stay safe when you're walking home, coming to school, in the parking lot. And yeah, be sure you're following the rules with crossing the roads. And then be sure to have your lunch numbers ready when you get in line for lunch, because it makes it go faster. And yeah. And then also the school's requesting, if you're going to pick up your student, please pick them up by 2:30. So it helps with the end of the day.
For PTSA news and updates, we have successfully raised $4,200. There's some volunteer opportunities seeking for various members in roles of the PTSA for the next academic year, and STEM night activity on January 18th. PTSA general meeting, it's virtual on January 25th.
Nice. Then some upcoming dates is on the 11th, we have a choir concert in the Union Cafeteria, 12th and 15th, we do not have school, so four-day weekend. 25th, there is a winter showcase in the Union Cafeteria. And then the 29th, there's the parent orientation for incoming sixth graders. And on the 6th, there's the start of the weekly parenting class focusing on challenges of raising teens. Then on the 19th, there's no school.
Not a lot of school.
Oh, just wait. There's going to come a period where we don't have any breaks. Like, it's right after spring break. We're going to go for 2 months straight and then be done. No breaks. So we get them in while we can.
Oh, boy.
Okay, you ready for my question for PBIS points?
Yeah.
First off, let's talk about the question from last week. Do you remember what the question was?
Something to do with...
Oh, man.
Well, something to do with history.
Yeah. But,
okay, so I asked people to come in and name at least one of the ancient seven wonders of the world.
This is what it was, yeah.
And hold on, give me a second. Did y'all ever figure out what one of them at least is?
Rome?
No. Do you know one of them?
Hanging Gardens of Babylon?
Yeah, Hanging Gardens of Babylon. Oh. I told y'all after, there's only one still around.
Pyramids of Giza.
Yeah, the Great Pyramid of Giza is one of them.
Great Wall of China one?
Nope. Oh, so the Hanging Gardens of Babylon, Great Wall of China is a modern, modern one. The Temple of Artemis, that is in Ephesus, Turkey. A statue of Zeus that was in Greece. Mausoleum at
Halicarnassus, the Colossus of Rhodes. There used to be a big statue overlooking a harbor, and to sail into the harbor, you had to sail under the statue's legs.
Oh.
And then the last one is there's this big lighthouse at Alexandria, and the lighthouse got burned down with the rest of Alexandria.
Dang.
So the pyramids are the only one that's left.
Okay.
So there's that. Okay, this week's. I made this one a little more difficult because this one is, okay, kind of. Got to do a little research. So this week's question for PBIS points, I'll give you unlimited attempts because it is a tougher question. The question is, who is Mr. S's favorite Roman emperor? So you got to do a little research. He is a more famous one. So,
any hints?
He's portrayed in a pretty famous Roman movie.
Okay.
So, and he's a pretty peaceful guy too. I'll give you that.
I have no clue what it is.
Well, that's why you got to do a little research. I'm not just going to give PBIS points for doing nothing.
Next week we will guess. I guess the podcast.
Yep.
Do I get PBIS points?
Sure.
If I guess it correctly.
Sure, absolutely.
Okay, I'll keep that in mind.
Yeah.
I need some potato chips.
Yeah.
All right. Well, hope we also have double episodes this week. So the episodes of Ms. McCann and then Mr. Barilla. So
yeah.
Yeah. All right. Well, we will see you guys next week.
All right. Have a good one. Bye.